रामायण इज नॉट जस्ट अ काव्य शास्त्र, इट इज नोन एज महाकाव्य. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फ्रॉम दिस ग्रेट काव्य, ग्रेट पोएट्री और महाकाव्य. नाउ वाल्मीकि हिमसेल्फ सेज इन द रामायण दैट वेदास प्रातेचसादासित साक्षात रामायणात्मनः, मीनिंग व्हेन लॉर्ड राम केम टू दिस अर्थ then Vedas came as Ramayan. So meaning the essence of all the Vedic scriptures are there in Ramayan. That is the beauty and uniqueness of Ramayan. In simple terms, I can say Shastra is for intellect and Kavya is for heart. Because when someone reads Kavya, it becomes very easy, it becomes soothing for them to understand and go deeper in the Kavya, the scriptures. And the scriptures, the Kavya also explains Shastra in a very emotional way. So that is one of the purpose of Lord's incarnation. Why God has to take so many incarnations in this world? So that He gives the philosophy. What is philosophy? It is a truth. It is the absolute truth, the purpose of life. It answers questions like, where was I before my birth? And what is the purpose of this life? What will happen after I die? And the purpose of life. These things are explained in Vedas, Upanishads, in the Shastra. But the same philosophy, when it is given with adding rasa or emotions in that, then it becomes Kavya. So I'll repeat, this is a very important point. Shastra is for intellect and Kavya is for heart. Now, there are three levels of understanding scriptures. So we can understand scriptures in three levels. Number one, historical. So what is historical? Historical means, yes, Ramayana, Mahabharata, all these itihasas and the story of God's presence on this earth did happen at one particular point in time and one particular place. This is history. So we can understand scriptures as a history, historical. And second, as philosophical. So because scriptures gives us the truth, it explains the absolute truth. We can also understand philosophy through these scriptures. And third, we can understand as psychological. So what is psychological? Meaning it is human psychology. So when we read scriptures, like for example Ramayana, there are so many things we can understand from Ramayana. How to deal with parents, how to deal with wife, how to deal with husband, how to take care of children, art of parenting, financial management. So all aspects of life needs a person's psychology. Because whatever we do, it affects our psychology. When there are two people fight, how a person responds to that situation depends on one's psychological capability. So in our discussion, in our journey, that is learning life lessons, lifestyle management lessons from Vedic scriptures, we will be discussing the historical level, the philosophical and also psychological part of Vedic scriptures. But we will be focusing more on psychological aspect. Now, a quiz questions to all of you. So I'll ask questions and you can think about the answer. So first question, there are famous brothers in Ramayana. So the first question, who are famous two brothers? Think about it. Who are famous three brothers in Ramayana? Think about it. Who are famous four brothers in Ramayana? I hope all of you got the right answer. So let us see what is the right answer. Who are famous two brothers? They are Vali and Sugriva. And all of us know Vali and Sugriva were living in Kishkindha. And who are famous three brothers? That is Ravana, Kumbhakarna and Vibhishana. And all of us know that Ravana, Kumbhakarna, Vibhishana, they're all actually were like demoniac. Among these brothers, Vibhishana was not demoniac. He was a devotee of Lord Ram. He always wanted to travel in the path of Dharma. But Ravana and Kumbhakarna always took the path of Adharma. That we clearly see when we hear the entire story of Ramayana. Now, who are famous four brothers? Yes, it is our favorite. Ram, Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughna. and these four brothers are the children of Dasharatha, the emperor of Ayodhya.